Hello, delegates. This is the campaign of Bill Lee, candidate for Utah County Commissioner Seat B. And before you go to convention tomorrow, Bill would like to discuss economic growth with you, specifically his approach of the unconventional wisdom of applied principles over politics. Because you see, every year you hear all the county commissioner candidates tell you they want to promote economic growth. But this year, the question to the candidates needs to be, specifically, what kind of growth are you talking about? For example, here's an idea that a couple of county commissioners had a few years ago to promote growth. Let's tax existing private businesses and their customers, and let's use those tax dollars to build a government-owned business that will take customers away from those private businesses, and while taking those customers away, this government-owned business is going to operate at a loss of almost $3,200 a day, and it'll need to be subsidized each year with a continual stream of even more tax dollars. Sounds crazy, doesn't it? But that's exactly what the county commissioners approved when they built the Utah Valley Convention Center to promote economic growth. At the grand opening of the center, an incumbent county commissioner said the building would be paid for by tourists, and, quote, "This is going to produce literally millions of dollars for this economy, both in sales tax and economic benefits." Well, let's take a quick look at how well the UVCC is doing. After incurring $38 million in bonding debt to build the center, in the first year of day-to-day operations and debt service, it resulted in a loss of more than $2 million. That's $2 million that had to be paid for with Utah County tax dollars. And then last year, the cost of operations and debt service was just over $1.1 million. And once again, that shortfall had to be covered with Utah County tax dollars. Now, even committed optimists would find it hard to describe this as, quote, economic growth, especially when it's costing almost $3,200 a day just to keep the doors open. That's not the worst part, because when the doors are open, a lot of the business being quote-unquote generated isn't really growth at all. It's just local customers being taken away from private businesses that already existed before the center was built. To illustrate this, take a look at this event calendar for the center for this current month of April 2014. As you can see, there's only three events booked there this month. First, last Friday, the Utah Valley Chamber of Commerce held their Friday forum there. And then this weekend, while we're at convention, the bridal fair is there. And then the Utah Valley Gun Show comes in the last week of April. Now think about that. First of all, the Utah Valley Chamber of Commerce certainly aren't tourists, and they're certainly not generating any new revenues for the county. Next, the bridal fair has been hosted for several years elsewhere in the county, including down at Provo High School in 2012. So any increase in business this weekend at stores and restaurants near the convention center is just business being taken away from stores and restaurants that were located near Provo High, and shifting dollars from one set of businesses to another can't be called economic growth. And finally, the Utah Valley Gun Show probably isn't bringing in that many tourists, but whatever tourists they are bringing in, if the UVCC Center didn't exist over here, those tourists would have certainly come in to the Marriott Center just a block away if the gun show had to be held there. Once again, moving revenue dollars a block away is not an economic gain. So as you decide who your next Utah County Commissioner is going to be, here's the takeaway that it's most important. If Bill Lee was your Utah County Commissioner, he would never have approved this plan, period. Because while Bill is just as interested in promoting economic growth as other candidates and incumbents proclaim to be, he understands and has committed to hold firm to three common sense principles that are needed to make sure our public tax dollars aren't squandered and our existing businesses aren't harmed. First principle, government shouldn't be in the business of business, period. I mean, let's face it, if building a convention center a block away from an existing conference center was a profitable way to attract tourists, then why would taxpayers have to pay for any part of it? Second principle, businesses shouldn't be compelled to collect and pay taxes to subsidize competing businesses, period. Especially when the business generated like a bridal fair and gun show would have happened anyway. And finally, government shouldn't be obligating future tax dollars or bonding without voter referendum approval. You would think county government would have learned that from the failed iProvo and Utopia ventures, but apparently not. And that's why Bill is running for Utah County Commissioner. That's why he did research into the convention center's bottom line that the other candidates haven't done yet and is reporting the news to you. And that's why those of us who support Bill Lee ask you to join us at the convention on Saturday and help elect him to County Commission Seat B. We'll see you there.